Bo Jordan, right after a hearty workout here at the Graham Wrestling Room. Bo, Buckeyes.
Yes.
Why Ohio State?
Best place for me. Best place for me personally. They're going hard, have the right priorities. I feel like it's the right atmosphere for me. Everyone's training and building off each other. Everyone wants to win that national title, team national title. I just feel everyone training for that, really building together, coming together as a team. Coaches are great. Coaches help me out. I mean, before I was even, when I was just in there, wrestling before even, you know, was really interested in it, coming to the RTC once, you know, they're helping me out, just as well as any other guy in the room that was just working out there that got fourth or higher at the state tournament, you know. I feel like they're just trying to get everyone as best as they can be. They made Logan, I think, beat one of the best guys pound for pound in the country. Hunter was right up there, beat the number one, number two ranked guy. Cam, same thing. I feel like everyone, they're just bringing everyone to that next level. That's how I want to go.
Those guys have been coming here since they were little kids. You were a little kid. You know, how much influence does that have on your decision, Stevers, Tassari, and potentially Phillips, if Phillips, you know, gets in or whatever his situation is. But how much does that play into your decision?
A lot. A lot. I mean, those guys, I haven't seen those guys coming here since they were, I mean, where I'm at now and younger, from 8th grade on up, seeing them coming here and train, and then go right into Ohio State and have success there, as well as from here. Easy transition. You know, it's close. It's in state. And they're going right to the next level right here at Ohio State. So why go anywhere else in the nation when I can stay at Ohio State and they're making guys excel? I think it's the best place for me, and I just love the atmosphere there. Everyone's really building off each other. So it's good.
Madison's 8.5 hours away. I think Penn State's probably about 6.5 hours away.
Yeah, something like that.
So those were the other two options. Madison, because, you know, your dad and your uncle and your cousins, two of your cousins. But when you look at that, being only an hour or 45 minutes away, do you look at that as an advantage or a disadvantage?
I look at that as an advantage. It didn't come down to that, though. That wasn't where my decision lied. Where I made my decision was where it could be the best I could be. If I go there, I mean, if it was Maryland, Cal Poly, I mean, all across the nation, wherever I could go to be the best wrestler I could possibly be, that's where I was going to go. But that was Ohio State for me. So, I mean, yeah, definitely an advantage being that close, but I felt where that's the best that I could be and excel in college wrestling, and just keep my priorities set straight, stay in the right atmosphere, training hard, keep my nose clean, and just, you know, training for that national title right out of as a true freshman or a freshman, whatever it is. I feel like I can be ready to try to make a run at the national title there and be the best I can be right off the bat.
Did David Taylor reach out to you for the whole, you know, in the Penn State part of it, and you know, Coach Sanderson? Did David reach out to you? You know, you from the same high school.
Yeah.
He's known your dad forever. He's a four-time state champ for your dad.
Yeah.
Was that something, you know, did David really reach out to you?
Yeah. I mean, he didn't, like, super reach out to me, but he, like, definitely, when I was up there, I went up there for my unofficial. I just wanted to check it out, see what it was like. David was there, you know, came in, gave my dad and my mom a hug, gave me a handshake, you know, hugged me and talking with me in the wrestling room, everything like that. Talked to my mom and dad forever. You know, it was great. I love David. You know, he's a great wrestler. He's, I mean, probably one of the best there is right now in college wrestling. He's done great things there. And, you know, I was kind of thinking that. I kind of feel like our styles are kind of the same, but I just feel like Ohio State was a better place for me. But even after I committed, you know, he texted my dad, you know, tell him, congratulations. I was real glad he, you know, got a full ride, all that stuff. I wish he could have been, you know, in the white, wearing blue and white, but congratulations to him. So, I mean, you know, just great. And I loved, if I could have been there with him, I feel like I could have really built with him a lot, and that would have been great to be able to, you know, kind of try to follow in his footsteps, follow in Kale's footsteps, and kind of, you know, just build up from there. But it didn't work out. I went to Ohio State, but, you know, it's great. I love it. Can't wait to wrestle there. So.
Okay, so we're going to shift gears to the pound for pound.
Pound
I keep
pound.
Seeing the pound for pound. I think Willie, we did the new flow rankings. He put Mark Steller ahead of you.
Yeah.
Mark Steller knew he's probably got maybe 10 pounds on you. Is that a matchup, something you would look at later on in the future?
That'd be great. It'd be great. I'm going 60 next year. I decided to go 60. I was going to go 52. I'm weighing right now. At the end of the week, I'll get down to 63, but on the weekend, I'll be up to 70. You know, kind of my weight's kind of fluctuating, but I'm staying 60 right now. Get ready for college. Wrestle maybe those a little bit bigger, stronger guys. Get ready for college. Go after everyone, you know. If Marshall Teller comes to 60, maybe Iron Man or something, that'd be a great match. I love him. You know, he's a great wrestler. That'd be a great match, I think, just for wrestling as well as just Iron Man. So that'd be a great matchup. I'd love to wrestle him. I know he's tough. You know, I've seen videos of him. It'll be good. It'll be a good match. But,
do you look forward for a matchup with the Iron Man finalist last year from California?
Martinez. Yeah, I mean, I don't really, it doesn't matter to me. Not that I wouldn't want to wrestle him, but I do want to wrestle him. But I mean, if they're at my weight, I'll go after him. You know, it's not going to matter who's there. I'll, you know, try to wrestle hard, go after him. get all I've got. Now, right now, I want to win Ironman title, want to win state title. That's my, you know, my priorities. But number one priority now is national title. I really want to train for national title and try to make it in college. I'm so excited for that. Wish I was like going into college next year as much as I want my senior year. It'd be great. I'm just real excited for it. Real excited to start training with the Stever brothers, you know, Cam, Phillips, Garcia, Demas, all those guys in there. I'm just real excited for it. So, yeah, I mean, if they're there at 60, both of them are, maybe neither will be. Whoever's there, it'll be good. It'll be a good match. So,
how do you not lose interest? You know, your dad said the same thing. You just said it. You really want to be at Ohio State. It's going to be hard to want to be here your senior year. How do you stay interested for your senior year here, Graham?
Just keep training. I know I got another year to try to prepare to win a national title in college, as well as, you know, try to go on, win another Ironman title and state title. But I got another year, get the best and work my hardest, get the best out of that year I can get to be a national champ, help Ohio State try to win their first national title, and, you know, be a four-time state champ or Ironman champ.
57, 65, 74, what's the weight going to be? Do you know yet?
I don't know. It just depends, I guess, once I get there. I mean, it doesn't really matter. It depends on how big I get, I guess, and what the coaches want me to go, what's best for the team, what's best for me, you know, kind of all those thrown in there. I have to talk to the coaches and see where it's best to go at, 65 or 57. I don't really know where I'm going to go yet, though.
Your dad said last time you guys went, you got the best of him. Do you realize your dad's gunning for you now? He said you're gunning for him. Or he's gunning for you.
Yeah, he's training hard. He's lifting.
He said he's riding his bike up hills, coming for you. Do you get scared at all?
I'm scared. It's different. When I wrestle him, kind of get that match feeling. You know, he's tough, real tough. It doesn't matter. I feel like he can just come in after not training for about half a year. Come in and for a 6-minute match, he can go. He can go, you know? Just like up at the gym, same thing. He comes in, I don't know how he gets it, I swear.
Comes from a session of Congress and he can wrestle?
He'll be in there, come in, like Max is senior, Max Thompson, comes in, you know, right from Washington, comes in, just beats the tar. No, I'm not talking like beat the tar, but I mean like took him down, rode him, controlled the whole match.
It's like 50.
Yeah, and he comes in with all the guys, can do that, you know, same with my dad. They just come in for that one match, they got it, you know? It's good. It's good stuff. But yeah, so when I wrestle him, you know, I'm going to kick it up a notch, try to, you know, give it my all. I got the best of him last time, but kind of got lucky. So we'll see how it goes next one.
All right, let's see that juicy ear. Bring it into the camera a little bit. Looks like your ear's a little juicy. Let me see it. Let's see it. Where'd that battle scar come from?
Right here?
Yep.
Wrestling. I was even wearing my head gear too. So I feel like you wrestle enough, doesn't matter if you wear your head gear or not, you're going to get cauliflower. It's kind of a wrestler's thing. So, you know, hit it, keep scraping it. I don't wear my head gear now. I don't like it in practice. You get hot, especially in here. You keep going those 1 minute go, you start burning up. So I just take it off, but, you know, it gets scraped, you're rubbing, you're trying to fight head position.
Part
of the deal.
All right, hey, you got anything else for me?
No.
All right. We'll be seeing you in Columbus next 4 to 5 years. All right, bud?
Yeah, sounds good.